Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I will be doing Apollo 13, but I will be doing it more in kind of a movie style with a bit less commentary, but there still will be a bit of commentary. I hope you enjoy. It took me a while to do this.
We're go for launch. T-minus
15.
Good flight, right down the middle.
We see your VPC is clear 13.
Roger, EDS to manual. Inboard. Get ready for a little choke, fellas.
Booster, can you confirm that center engine cutoff?
Roger, that flight looks like we lost it.
Vito, what's that going to do to it?
Stand by, flight.
I need to know if the IU is correcting for the number 5 shutdown.
Yes, it was the story on engine 5.
Looks good. We're still go.
We'll be all right as long as we don't lose another one.
Roger that.
13, we're not sure why the inboard was out early, but the other engines are a go, so we're just going to burn those remaining engines for a little bit longer.
13, stand by for staging.
Roger that.
15, shut down. The ignition.
Flight S will be cut off in 10 seconds.
13, this is Houston. The predicted cutoff is 12 plus 3, 4. Over.
Coming up on 12 minutes 34. And
Seiko!
Cut down!
And that, gentlemen, is how we do that.
Roger.
The Apollo 13 crew would then do a burn called the translunar injection burn after three orbits. This is the burn that would set them on target to get to orbit the moon. On this burn, the S-4B stage would relight its engine, something that was rarely done by rockets. The only other things that could do this were the lunar module and the command service module. They would need to raise their apoapsis to get all the way to the moon. Apollo 13 crew would then turn the ship and do a mid-course correction burn so they wouldn't crash into the moon. Also, their moon landing was going to land in the Fra Mauro Highlands, so they needed a special trajectory different than all the other moon landing missions. This got them off of their free return trajectory that would get them back home in case they had an accident.
And then if you could give your oxygen tanks a stir.
Roger that.
Houston, say again, please.
Houston, we have a problem. We have a main bus being undervolt. We've got a lot of thruster activity here, Houston. It just went offline. Oh, there's another master alarm, Houston.
I'm checking a quad.
Christ, that was no refresh valve.
Maybe it's a quad.
We've got a computer restart.
I'm going to reconfigure the RCS.
We've got a big light.
When these things fire, doesn't make any sense.
We've got multiple caution and warning, Houston. We've got a reset and restart.
All right, I'm going to SDS.
Flight, the heart rates are skyrocketing.
Econ, what's your data telling you?
O2 tank 2 not reading at all. Tank 1 is at 725 PSI and falling. Fuel cells 1 and 3 are, what's going on here? Flight, let me get back to you. Flight GNC? Flight, they're all over the place. They keep going close to gimbal lock.
I keep losing radio signal. Flight, their antenna must be
22. They're going to have to do it manually.
One at a time, people. One at a time. One at a time. Econ, is this an instrumentation problem, or are we looking at real power loss here?
It's reading a quadruple failure. That can't happen. It's got to be instrumentation.
Let's get that hatch button. The limb might have been hit by a meteor.
Yeah,
the tunnel's really torquing with all the
fluid. Houston, we got a pretty large bang there associated with a master alarm. Shit, it's main bus A.
Main bus A undervolt?
Houston, we have a main bus A undervolt now, too. It's reading 25 and a half. They must be is reading SIMP right now. But we got a wicked shimmy up here.
Ecom, GNC, these guys are talking about bangs and shimmies up there. Doesn't sound like instrumentation to me.
The Apollo 13 astronauts would then move into the lunar module. Even though it was only meant to hold two people, it would keep the three of them alive for the next 4 days until they got back to Earth. They then did another correction burn with the lunar module engine because the command module or the service module engine had been damaged by the explosion. They corrected their course so they would be on a free return trajectory, though they would still have to speed themselves up more later. The Apollo 13 crew would then do a burn around the moon, but this would not be the lunar orbit insertion burn. They did an STP-2 speed-up burn around the back of the moon to speed themselves up so they would be on target and get to the Earth. after yet another burn with their lunar module engine, but this time much closer to Earth, to correct their course. They would do another one with their RCS thrusters this time, though, just to get them a tiny bit more on their course. They would be set to splash down near Hawaii on April 17th. Once they got close enough to Earth, they separated from the damaged service module. They then used the lunar module to take pictures of the service module once it spun around. Once the service module turned so they could see it, they could see that an entire panel had been blown out by the damaged exploding oxygen tank, taking some of the fuel cells and batteries with it. This was one, they took a famous picture that I'll show in this video later. The command module Odyssey would then separate from the lunar module Aquarius. Aquarius would then propel itself to go land off the coast of Australia.
Signal in 3 minutes.
you to the MVRS for the launch, the James Horner community for the docking music and the Dark Side of the Moon music. The Houston We Have a Problem scene came from movie clips, so thank you. And thank you to Planet Clips and BSO Soundtrack for the reentry and splashdown music and audio.